I've been in the entrepreneurial aspects of medicine for the last 26 years, and it's been fun. It has allowed me to do things that I wouldn't have done as a university professor in the more traditional sense. I've been somewhat successful in some of my entrepreneurial activities. One of them was the founding of a company called Anesta and the development of a concept of potent drugs in lollipops. And the fentanyl lollipop was born and turned out to be not a bad idea. Part of my background was to develop very potent drugs that could be put in a dart and safely dart moose and elk and deer. And that kind of research led to me studying monkeys, misting monkeys, to see if that would work to put them to sleep safely and rapidly. We were doing these monkeys with some veterinarians actually in California for this experiment, and the vet said, could you put some of that stuff in a sugar cube? So we injected some, and monkey started and boom, with a couple of smacks on, you know, sucks on this sugar cube, he was knocked out and safely. And so on the way back from Sacramento to Salt Lake, I'm at 35,000 feet thinking, monkeys, how can we do this for people? And that's where the idea of putting a drug in the lollipop and giving it to a child who needed to have surgery. The reason why I believe faculty should be at least open to the potential for commercialization is because that's the way good ideas and great ideas get to be real products that help real people with their real problems.